Hello everyone, I'm Yogita Sethi, the Ahmedabad Chapter Secretary of Image Management Professionals Association. A hearty welcome to Sapna Kedia, the featured consultant of the month, and I request our chapter president, Nidhi Shah, to introduce Sapna.
Thank you, Yogita. Welcome, Sapna. A very warm welcome to all our viewers. I would like to introduce Sapna a little bit, and then we would like to hear more about her from her own experiences. So Sapna is one of the most active practicing image consultants from ICBI Ahmedabad. From a business solely devoted to changing looks, she has focused on changing lives through customized workshops and consults her clients on outer and inner change through image and soft skills. Her career has been about helping others and building confidence. She has adorned leadership roles in this industry by serving as the president of IMPA, Ahmedabad chapter, for 2 years. Sapna is an educator, conducting trainings and inspiring aspiring image consultants. She is also the recipient of the prestigious Times Power Women Award 2019 by Times of India. And there are lots of things that we would love to know about Sapna. And I would request Yogita to ask questions so that we can know Sapna in a more deeper way.
Well, firstly, Yogita and Nidhi, I would want to thank you both for being so kind and for the beautiful introduction that you have given. It would be an absolute pleasure for me to share about myself.
So, Sapna, we would like to ask you about your past background.
Well, Nidhi, I started my professional career as a part-time teacher. And then I progressed in the same field, in the same industry. I became a supervisor. I became a cultural coordinator in one of the most esteemed schools in Ahmedabad. And that is how I started my career. I was into teaching for 10 big years.
Wow. And how did you get to know about the image consulting profession?
So while I was into this teaching, I was on sabbatical for medical reasons. And it is then that I actually got to read newspapers and, you know, I got a little time for myself. It is then that I came across this advertisement of ICBI in Times of India. And I could so much relate to what was written there. Like, I felt that I was always made for that. And that is how I, approached ICBI. And then I decided to pursue the course.
That's fantastic. And tell us about the kind of work you are doing after your certification.
Well, Yogita, I feel myself absolutely lucky that I did my certification, because after that, so once my certification was done, I feel there was no looking back. Year to year, month to month, I kept on upgrading myself regarding work, regarding my own skills. And I have been doing a lot of work for colleges, again, which is very close to my heart, because I have always been into teaching. So I conduct trainings in many colleges of Ahmedabad. I am an onboard trainer with one of the biggest MNCs. So I conduct trainings for them in many states in India. So I travel. And also, one of the biggest achievement I feel is that I have conducted trainings for IAS officers on team building, time management. So it is, there that I really feel that I have upgraded myself, and I think yet there is a long way to go.
Super.
Sapna, like you mentioned, you have been doing a lot of work with MNCs. What do you think, like specifically when we talk about Ahmedabad or Gujarat or then India, because you said that you travel also. So what kind of an awareness about this industry is present in corporates?
So Nidhi, you know what? So I am sure we all are from the same industry, and you would agree that the awareness has started, and the corporates have started realizing that yes, there is a gap, and it is very necessary for you to project yourself as a brand. So they find this gap, they want to upgrade themselves, but the challenge what I feel here is that they don't know that services like this exist. Yeah, so they are searching for such services, but they don't know what to name it and how to approach it. So let me say there is a huge need. There is a big need. It is like we just need to explore, and it is on the it is still rising. So I think anyone who is coming into this industry for another 2 to 3 years, it is going to be great for them.
Well, good. For 2 to 3 years, yes. But what do you think about this profession as a lucrative profession for the coming decade, especially when we have seen this pandemic happening? And, you know, like for corporate workshops, I'm sure everything just came online. It will still take some time to get onto those offline trainings. So what do you think about the coming decade?
Well, Nidhi, I have got 3 good reasons. So I would start the reason with firstly, what you said during this lockdown and, you know, all the corporate world. So I just feel before the lockdown, before this pandemic, when we used to walk on the roads or travel on the roads, we used to see these hoardings. Right. So that is how a brand was created and recognized. And now we travel in social media platforms. And we come across these videos and these creatives. So I again feel that is branding, isn't it? So as much it is necessary for you to have a good product, equally it is necessary for you to market it. And for that, you need to have your own brand. You need to create your own brand. So I think now it has still become more important, more lucrative. And, you know, the horizons have still broadened when it goes to image consulting. So that is my first reason. The second is the best part about this career is anyone can pursue it, right? So either it be any gender or it be he or she can be from any background. The only thing is they need to have passion for this industry. Right. So that is another thing. And the third, what I feel is there is something known as a business curve, right? And there are 3 stages in business curve. First stage is when you rise. This is how the curve goes when the industry is still rising. The second stage is there comes a stagnant phase in the industry. And a third is then either you rise up or you go down. So this is the business curve. For us, it is still rising. So as I said, what I foresee is for another 2 to 3 years, it would still rise. So I really, really feel that there is a huge lot of scope for this industry, and anyone who has passion for this should definitely, you know, go for this. So we still feel there is so much of work coming, and we are short in hands for this work. So this is what I feel.
Great. So provided that there's a lot of work, I'm sure that everybody has a different blueprint and a different roadmap to success. So this tempts me to ask you further that what is your roadmap to success?
Well, Nidhi, for me, I would just say that, you know, you would agree, because even you have been a trainer, that we cater a very limited group of people when we do trainings or consulting. And we, as image consultants, one skill that I feel we are now blessed with is we can bring transformation in lives of people. So now after 5 years, I want to focus on bringing a change in the society at large. And I want to cater a bigger group of people. So for that, I really, really want to write few books so that they are easily approachable. Anyone who wants to anyone who wants a help or can just approach it. So because when we are conducting training, not everyone and anyone can be a part of it. So that is what I'm willing to do further.
That's amazing.
Yes, a very noble thought. And somehow I feel that most of us who take this up as a profession, I think for us, what matters is making a difference in people's lives, whether it's on individual basis or a group basis. So we all are on the same page and in the same boat, I think, to make that small visible difference.
Yes.
In that one person also that we meet.
Yeah, Nidhi, and I'm sure you would agree that, you know, it gives us that kick to make someone else satisfied, make someone else help achieve their dreams. So I really think that is the best part about image consulting, when you make differences in the lives of people.
Absolutely, absolutely. So it's been 5 years, right, Sapna, that you have been teaching kids, and now you're teaching young adults and adults. So you are consulting and coaching them, like we have those fancy words. So what is it that still excites you about this industry? And, you know, I would also want you to answer this last question, that what are those differences that you have seen in your life after being an image consultant?
Well, Nidhi, this question is very close to my heart. So, so we know each other since last 5 years, and you would agree that I have always been overweight and plus size, right? Okay, wait, hold on. I have a story to say. So, I was not comfortable in my skin. My bulges, my curves would make me feel low in confidence. When I stood in front of mirror, I could see Amit Shah standing in front of me, because one thing that was common between both of us was the extra crease and the double chin. So I used to, believe me, I used to follow every eye that felt on me. I used to look down, is there something that is bulging out? I used to hide myself behind me. That is what actually is something, that is the reason why I did image consulting. To worsen things out, my gray hair had started popping out. So then it all changed once I became an image consultant. When I started studying image consulting, people say, you better enjoy your investments. And it is now that I make people enjoy each and every moment of their life. Today, I sit and gossip with my curls, and I'm so very much comfortable doing that. My each strand of gray hair tells a story of my experience, which makes me different from the millennials. Instead of hot flashes, I have crushes now. My husband flirts with me every single day. I give tips on how to have a wonderful date. I help people take a blind date with themselves and be more confident. I help them accept and celebrate their body. So my tagline has changed from the perfect body to being comfortable in everybody. So Nidhi, this has been my journey, and I know the changes that I've felt in myself after being an image consultant. And I would want to pass down the same confidence, the same changes to each and every individual who thinks that, you know, their body is not perfect.
Well said.
Really well said, Sapna. And I think there is no love like self-love. And that is why we say that we bring change not only superficially, it's not a makeover, but we as image consultants, we try and we actually make sure that we are bringing, an image enhancement inside out. And I think your story inspires us, because you have applied it on yourself. So that's why you can also claim and boast about it, that yes, this is what I have done to myself, and that's what I can bring on the table and do the same for you and do the same for the clients. So very inspiring, Sapna. I still remember those initial years when we met and when I see you now. So there's a drastic change for better. And I'm so, so happy and sure also that you're going to make lots and lots of differences in millions of people. So thank you so much for being here and sharing your journey. It really makes a lot of difference. And I'm sure even one of the viewer, if there is a takeaway for them, it's worth our time and energy. So thank you so much, Sapna. And to you, Yogita.
I absolutely
definitely, Nidhi. Thank you so much for having me here. Thank you, Yogita, as well. And yes, together we all would make a difference, I am sure.
I absolutely love your sense of humor and how you expressed yourself today. I thoroughly enjoyed listening to you and thank you so much.
Thanks, Yogita.
Thank you, everyone.